Hi guys, it's Morgan from Rogers CPA Review. It's August of 2009. Welcome to your CPA exam passport. Every year, the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants holds a conference for all of the CPA review courses. Just as always, Roger was in attendance, and he's here today to bring you guys any updates to the CPA exam and what you can expect to find in the next year or two.
Thanks, Morgan. Hey, I just returned from the AICPA meeting in New York with some exciting information. First of all, the pass rates seem to have inched up just a little bit. They're on average about 48 to 50%. Again, my pass rates are the highest in the industry of about 86%. A couple of the changes, though, that are upcoming, probably not till about the fourth quarter of 2010. That would be the earliest. First of all, with fair audit and reg, those three parts currently are 70% multiple choice, 20% simulation problems, and 10% written communication. What they plan to do is move that 10% written communication, the essay portion, from all three of those parts, audit, fair, and reg, and move them over to BEC. So BEC will probably have three essays, of which two are graded and one is just a pre-tested question. They're also talking about moving some of the time from audit, which is currently 4.5 hours, most likely over to BEC. That means the total exam won't change. It'll still be 14 hours, but they're just gonna kind of reshuffle. Probably make auditing a little bit shorter and BEC a little bit longer. As far as fair audit and reg, they're still going to have simulations, but instead of having two very detailed simulations on two different topics, they'll have eight short little simlets. Of those eight simlets, six will be graded and two will be pre-tested or thrown out, not part of your score. But those will be shorter question, and they're going to be more, a little bit more on research and some of the definitional information, calculations as well. One of the things I like about that is right now you might study pensions over and over, and there's very little or nothing on the exam. Now, instead of having two long problems, you'll have eight shorter problems, which means there's a higher probability that more information will be covered that you've already studied. So again, those are some of the changes. Probably the earliest period, again, is fourth quarter 2010. My guess is first quarter 2011, so it gives them plenty of time to roll that out. A couple of other informational things that you should know is generally quarter three and quarter four are the busiest quarters when people are taking the exam. The other thing too is the scoring results. Generally, currently, they release them twice in a window. They plan to, in the future, release them four times in a window. That way, you'll get the information a little more timely. As has mentioned in the past, if you take it one window and you don't pass, then you can take it in the next window. Now, at least, you'll get your score a little bit earlier in the process. Again, that's just some of the exciting information. Stay tuned, and we'll get you more soon.
Thanks, Roger. And keep in mind that we'll keep bringing you any additional updates to the CPA exam as we hear them from the AICPA. Thanks for watching, and make sure to tune in next time to your CPA exam passport, bringing you the world of CPA exam review. See you later.